Republic for this. You never truly fail until you stop trying.
So all we're going to do is drop the Q of X in where it's Q, and I think the Q, wait, it was P, what was the first one? P is the first, Q is the second. So we have X cubed plus X squared Y plus X minus X times P, which is Y cubed plus XY squared plus Y. All right, so we got some simplification to do. Might as well factor the 3 out of the numerator while we're at it. Denominator, yx cubed plus x squared y squared plus xy. I'm writing, well, I thought I was writing alphabetically ordered. We'll turn the first term into x cubed y instead of yx cubed. All right, now we're subtracting everything over here. Xy cubed minus x squared y squared minus xy. So minus xy plus xy cancels. X cubed y, there's no other x cubed y, but I do have x squared y squared minus x squared y squared. All right, so we're going to cancel those guys. 3y squared minus x squared divided by x cubed y minus xy cubed. So I think every algebra move I made up to here was relatively straightforward. Nothing too strange. This is what I would call the simplifying part. Now I have to turn it into, let's see. What is case 3? It's a function of x times y. So I'm trying to write this as a function of x times y. So you need to know what your goal is. So what I have to do is get every x and y to appear as basically x times y. So this can be a little easier said than done, although I don't think I said it very well. Maybe be done more easily than said. We don't have difference of cubes. Okay, we do have, wait.
We can factor out an xy, right?
We can factor out an xy. They're not quite difference of cubes. I mean, I could force the issue if I wrote cube root of x cubed y cubed minus, we do, and this is in fact very valid to do.
I was thinking about
at certain times. Okay. We've taken, like, for example, I've factored a minus b into square root a minus square root b, square root a plus square root b. There's times where that's useful. So you could do the same thing with a instead of a 1/2 power, you can do the same thing with a third power. But I don't think we need to do that right here. And we're left with x squared minus y squared. That looks right. So how do I go about canceling these two factors? They almost cancel.
Factor out a negative 1.
So they're basically negatives of each other. So if I could either factor out a negative 1. There's a few ways to do this. We'll factor a negative 1 out of the top. Now I can cancel. Negative 3 over xy. OK, so we finally get a function of x times y. There is a slight assumption. Well, there is an assumption or some xy value that will work down in the denominator, but won't work in the, let's see. I lost some information when I canceled these. What am I assuming when I cancel that out?
X squared doesn't equal y squared.
So those basically aren't zero. So x squared is not equal to y squared.